Okay, thank you for giving this opportunity. I'll try to summarize or give a highlight what Ethiopian biodiversity has been doing, particularly in plant biodiversity conservation in the last 39 years, in short, and in 5 minutes. I'll talk about the gene bank, conserved genetic resources, utilization aspects, challenges, and future aspects. So it has been mentioned this morning, there was an initiative in US, particularly in 1972, to have a plant genetic resource conservation all over the world. So Ethiopia was one of the centers of diversity, so Ethiopia was given an opportunity to have a gene bank. Actually, Ethiopia was recognized as one of the Babylon centers by Vavilov. Vavilov came to Ethiopia around 1927 with these old challenges. He came here not to do or to conduct research, but to collect seeds, particularly to support breeding program of Russia. This guy, Vavilov, has been striving to feed Russian people, and finally he died due to starvation in prison. The next explorer who came to Ethiopia and recognized Ethiopia as center of origin is Harlan, which is mentioned in this morning again. Harlan pointed four important issues. The first one is the variability in some of the Near Eastern crops is enormous in Ethiopia, and this diversity, so it's power? Okay. Okay, this diversity is very important for the world because Ethiopia was hosting this kind of diversity which is not found elsewhere. Issue which is concluded by Harlan. The second one is the Ethiopian Center provides us with unique opportunity to study genetic system. There are different kind of genetic systems in Ethiopia that will, so this is a good opportunity to conserve or to consider Ethiopian as one of center of diversity. And there is a serious study of Ethiopian center should throw some light on the relative antiquity of Near Eastern seed agriculture. Particularly, we have both seed agriculture in northern parts of our country. In southern part of our country, we have both seed and veggie culture, that is insect-based and root and tuber crops based. So that will give an opportunity to study historical aspects. And finally, his conclusion was Ethiopia still have an agricultural system which is not changed over several years. So that will give historical aspects how agricultural system have changed all over the world. So due to these facts, Ethiopia was considered as one of the center of genetic diversity and origin, and also given an opportunity to establish a gene bank in 1976. So we have enormous genetic resources, which is expressed in particularly 38 cultivated species, like wheat and barley, and also other species like sesame and coffee as well. The genetic diversity in Ethiopia is based on great geographic diversity, and as well as several macro and micro climatic conditions, particularly the altitudinal range, which is below sea level. We have around 116 up to 4,620 meters above sea level. We have about 10 major ecosystems, about 18 and 49 agro ecological zones. So following this geographic diversity, we have also enormous cultural diversity with more than 80 ethnic groups and languages. So overall, the geographic diversity as well as this altitudinal variation enabled Ethiopia to have about 6,500 to 7,500 flowering plants. Actually, now the Ethiopian flora writing is completed. Almost about 6,000 species are listed in these flora books, but still we are discovering new plants, either to science as well as also which are new to these flora books. Based on this, about 12% of flowering plants in Ethiopia is considered or recognized as an endemic. When I come back to the establishment of Plant Genetic Resource Center in Ethiopia to conserve the plant genetic resources, so Ethiopia was given high priority, and also the government of Germany was willing to assist Ethiopia in the establishment of gene bank. So it was started after, now the initial thought was in 1972 in USA, and then there is official request to undertake feasibility study, that is in 1973. Then feasibility study was conducted, funds made available, GIZ, now GIZ, then GTZ was assigned from German side, and the Ethiopian Agricultural Research Institute was charged for this execution of Plant Genetic Resource Center establishment from Ethiopian side. So in May 1976, bilateral contract agreement was signed. So we are going to celebrate our 14th years in the coming May. I hope it will be synchronized with the convention of the biodiversity day of the Convention of Biological Diversity. And then the construction of the gene bank, the one you will see on the left side of this building, was initiated in 1976. So in 1980, the main office laboratories were completed, and so the cold room was installed. Previous to 1986, just since 1973, they were conserving the seeds. Now it is near Arat Kilo, which is Turata Minister. What do you call it? Pension? Social Affairs, Ministry of Social Affairs, okay. So, then the major activities at that time was to promote collection, evaluation, and documentation of crop germplasm, and also to have germplasm in long-term storage and provide Ethiopia with Ethiopian researchers and also for other countries for improvement program. So, 1976 to 1987, almost Ethiopians were trained, and finally, since 1987, Ethiopians are now running the gene bank. So the crop gene bank, it has many processes, a very long process, starting from collection, then processing of seeds, drying of the seeds, testing germination viability. It should be to standard, that means all germplasm which is going to be stored in the cold room should have a germination capacity more than 85%. If it's less than 85%, we have to rejuvenate it. So we have seed health section, characterization, morphological, biochemical, and finally the cold room conservation. We have three cold rooms, which is adjusted at minus 10 degrees centigrade in the crop gene bank, and also one temporary room for which is adjusted at plus 4. When we see the collection trend in Ethiopian Biodiversity Institute, actually it was started before the establishment of the gene bank, because most of our collection, we'll see later on, are found abroad. So with repatriation, it started, and particularly from 1976, from the initial stage up to 1989, the collection trend was very, very high. And then some stagnation from 1990 to 2001. In 2002 and 2003, it was very high. Then from 2005 up to 2012, again, it was lagging. Now in 2013 and 2014, we have high, relatively high collection. Now 2015, now we are, the data is not entered, so it is very small. When we see the main holdings, we have more than 81,000 accessions, but most of the accessions are from a few crops, like barley, wheat, sorghum, teff, and filpi, finger plate, and coffee. So totally in our gene bank, including the forest gene bank, we have more than 500 species of crop, forage, tree, and medicinal plants. For coffee, we have a field gene bank at Choche, which has 22.5 hectare. There are some accessions of coffee and root and tuber crops, spices. We have also another coffee gene bank at Badesa, and also we have insect field gene bank at Angacha. Now we have also two more new coffee field gene banks at Yayu and Southern Nations and Nationalities. Plant genetic resource collection and conservation from Ethiopia has long history before the establishment of the Ethiopian Gene Bank. Particularly, these countries have our collections now. So, regarding our Gene Bank, we have we are required to have a safety duplicate, which is very important as a standard for Gene Bank. So Ethiopian government have allocated more than 25 million birr for this purpose. So we got about 8 hectares of land, 113 kilometers from here. And now we are going to make it functional in 2013, but more or less it starts its job. We have also, we have been also carrying out particularly in situ conservation activities since 1992. In this in-situ conservation of crop genetic resources, farmers play a very important role, and we have tried to include many agroecosystems for conservation of these plant genetic resources in-situ, particularly by constructing of 12 community gene banks. So through this in-situ system, we have been trying to maintain diversity within agricultural systems, to have more resilient climate-induced events, and also for it helped also to reintroduce some crops from ex-situ to in-situ. Regarding agrobiodiversity, just to highlight, we have now a five-year project which is working on TEF. Particularly in Minjar Shankora, and we have also Durhamit in one of Oradas. Particularly, you can see here, this is an improved one. This one is a farmer's variety. There was unexpected rain in 2008. The improved one holds all moisture, and finally it is damaged by fungal attack. But the landrace it bent down and there's no moisture accumulation. As a result, it was free from fungal attack. Here we have coffee, which is now we are trying to conserve in Yayu. And you can see 8 beans. Had it been it is improved, all will be at a similar stage. But such variability will help to escape disease or climatic conditions or many factors. We have insect, which is a staple food for 50 million people, which is consumed only in Ethiopia, except in Japan, where it is consumed for some festivals once a year. Organizational issue, it has been mentioned in this morning. Just I want to highlight that we have 7 biodiversity centers. There are also regional biodiversity units. We have 2 botanic gardens and 1 biodiversity duplicate. So we are now under establishment process of these biodiversity centers. I hope with the central part, which is left for EBI, the rest part of the country will be covered by these centers. We have also Fiche Biodiversity Gene Bank, which is the main duplicate. We have Jimma Botanic Garden, Shashamani Botanic Garden. And in Fiche, almost 95% of civil work is completed. Mechanical work is in process. We will have staff office, animal laboratory, and gene bank to duplicate both, not only plants, microbes as well as animals. This is animal barn and then animal feed. So it's a big institute which is constructed through the government budget without any external input. Another challenge, now we have more than 81,000 accessions of germplasm conserved in our gene bank. We are going to duplicate it to Fiji. If we duplicate every year 1,000 accessions, we need 81 years to complete the duplication. If we duplicate 8,000 per year, then we will complete it in 10 years. So how this is a challenge, how we are going to duplicate this germplasm over the next years. We have the forest gene bank where now we are now. It was funded by, again, GTZ. And so it helps us to establish gene bank for forest. And it is adjusted to minus 20 degrees centigrade. It has a capacity of 60 meter cube. So far, we have more than 2,000 accessions in the cold room as well as in the field gene bank. We have herbarium and also some in situ and ex situ sites. We have medicinal plant field gene banks, one in Bali, Bambasi, Kure, Wendogenet, and Zege. So we managed to conserve about 1,000 accessions in these field gene banks. Not only conservation, our genetic resources has been used for crop improvement program for yield, disease, climate, and so on. And particularly TEF, almost the materials which are conserved in our institute are the sole materials for the improvement program. In the future, now we are we have ambition to become center of excellence, so we have to meet international standards, particularly in improving our quality collections, in drying, regeneration, and so on. So we have to upgrade and expand forest gene bank because it is very small, only 60 meter cube. We have herbarium, which we need to upgrade again. Application of molecular tools in characterization, evaluation, and the DNA, and so on, that's very important. The database needs improvement. It should be supported by JRS lab. We need to digitize our herbarium specimens. We need to adopt conservation techniques and methodologies like tissue culture and so on. Increase in situ conservation areas, particularly in areas which we have never covered so far. So particularly the crop wild natives and weedy plants need attention because they are very important for crop improvement programs. We have many initiatives, particularly the Fiche duplicate gene bank, as I told you, needs a lot of work to bring it to make it functional and sustainable. And we have Shashamani Botanical Garden. Now we have office. We need a lot again to do there. Jima Botanic Garden, as well as coffee field gene banks. We have insect gene bank in Angacha, which needs again a lot of work. We have medicinal plant field gene banks. Again, a lot of works. And forest field gene bank in various parts of the country. And we have also, now we are establishing biodiversity centers, which we need to train the people. We are employing them. After employing, we have to train, and then they have to know what we should do in the future. So that requires a lot of huge work. That's all, thank you.